Hello everyone, welcome to my channel e-learning zone. Today we are going to do the poem The Shed by Frank Flynn. This is from Honeycomb class 7 NCERT. Now let us discuss a little about the shed. It is a small building that is usually used to keep things or animals. Maybe some of you even have it in your garden or in your kitchen garden, etc. It is like an outhouse, something that is outside your house. A little small temporary structure, a temporary building that is made outside your house to store the things. It is not a permanent building. Usually it has a temporary structure that resembles a hut. It holds garden tools, pesticides, etc. Usually the things that we cannot store in our house. It can be a building that is made of four wooden pillars with a tin sheet on top of it, or maybe it is a closed structure but not a very refined structure. So it is just a building, it is just a structure that houses your things which you cannot store in the house. It is like your gardening equipment, so it can be used as a shelter for the animals, or it could be used as a workshop. So this is about shed. I hope you got an idea what a shed is about. So now as you have got the idea what a shed looks like, let us start with explanation of the poem. There's a shed at the bottom of our garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I'm in bed, I lie and I listen. I'll open that door one day. So as you all know, this poem is about a shed. And the child who is the speaker here feels scared while passing through the shed. There's a shed at the bottom of the garden. Means there is a shed. The poet is saying, the little child is saying that there is a shed at the bottom of the garden, at the end of the garden. No one goes inside the shed, and that is why there are spider webs hanging on the door, with a spider's web hanging across the door. And then what happens? The hinges are rusty and creaks in the wind. When the wind blows, there is this creaking sound, and the hinges and the doors are rusty and make a lot of noise when the wind blows across them or when the wind moves them. This shows that the shed is not used for long. No one goes there, no one has bothered to oil the hinges. And then what happens? When I am in the bed, I lie and I listen. And the poet is from his bed. He is lying in his room on the bed and is listening to all these sounds that are there. The poet lies on his bed listening to the sounds coming from the shed, listening to the creaking of the hinges and the rusty hinges that are making the sound. He is listening to them sitting on his bed, lying down on his bed. I'll open that door one day. And he is very curious. He wants to open that door one day and see what is inside. And he is sure that he will open the shed one day to see what is there inside. He is curious to know about what is in the shed, and he wants to open the door and see what is there inside that room. What is there inside the shed? Why are the sounds coming? Why is it so mysterious? What is there? Why does no one go inside? He wants to see, explore all this going inside the shed one day. There's a dusty old window around at the side with three cracked panes of glass. I often think there's someone staring at me each time I pass. So here the poet says that there is a dusty old window at one side of the shed. Why it is dusty, why it is old? Because no one has been using that shed for long. No one is bothered to clean the shed. No one is bothered to repair the broken glass panes of the shed. So there is a dusty old window around at the side, and it has got three panes of glasses that are broken. No one is bothered to repair them. I often think there's someone staring at me. And then he has this feeling that someone is staring at him from inside the shed every time he passes by. Every time he crosses that shed, he feels that there is someone sitting there inside who is staring at him. The child, the poet, is quite scared of the presence of shed there. I'll peep through that window one day. My brother says there's a ghost in the shed who hides under the rotten floorboards. And if I ever dare to set foot inside, he'll jump out and chop off my head. But I'll take a peek one day. So now this little boy is very curious about to see what is there inside the shed. He wants to peep through the window and see what is there. And his elder brother, most probably the brother is the elder one, who is trying to bully this little younger fellow. My brother says there is a ghost in the shed. He says that there is a ghost, you don't go inside, who hides there in the rotten floorboards. The ghost is lying there in the rotten floorboard. And if ever you dare to set foot, the brother is warning here, this little fellow, that you should not dare to set a foot inside. You should not enter the shed at all. Because if you do so, the ghost that is present there is definitely going to chop off your head. But this little boy, the poet, is damn sure that one day he'll take a peek. He will see there what is inside the shed. He's so curious that he's not scared of any stories. He's not scared of any ghosts. But he's saying that definitely one day he'll take a peek inside the shed and figure it out himself what is there, what is present there. I know that there isn't really a ghost. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noises, and the spider has been gone from his web since I don't know when. I'll go into the shed one day soon, but not just yet. So now here, the poet is not scared. He's quite brave and intelligent. He says that he understands that there is no ghost in the shed. I know that there isn't really a ghost. He knows that there is no ghost in the shed. And the poet is aware that the brother is telling him lies because he wants to retain the shed for himself, for his own use. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. The brother wants to use his elder brother, most probably is the elder brother, who wants to use the shed for his own use. No one is staying at him. No one is making those strange noises. No one is actually there. No one is inside the shed. There isn't anyone staring or making those strange noises. There is nobody that is staying in the shed. Not even the spiders. And the spider has been gone from his web. The spider too has left the shed long back. Since I don't know when, and this is not known to anyone, when did the spider leave? So, but the poet don't want to explore the shed right now. He wants to wait. But I'll go into the shed one day soon, but not just yet. He wants to wait. He wants to get into the shed someday, but he does not know when. Someday he wants to see what is there inside, to see what's there, to know the real world inside. But he says that it is not immediately going to happen. But it is possible that someday in future that he goes there, takes a peek there, that he goes into the shed and explore the world inside on his own. I hope you have understood the poem well. If ever there is any doubt, don't hesitate to comment below. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button. Keep learning. Bye-bye.